the AVP at all things summer. And by McDonald's. Welcome back to the Huntington Beach Open, presented by Bud Light. Big crowd on hand to watch Kerri Walsh and Misty May. They've been doing some traveling in the past few weeks, Karch. Detail.
Well, yes, they have. They not only want to dominate the AVP Tour, but they want to dominate the World Tour also. So they're playing every off weekend on the AVP. They go back to Europe. We saw them earlier go to Europe and then to Paris. And last weekend, they were in Klagenfurt, Austria, racking up those frequent flyer miles. They've got plenty of miles to go on, plenty of vacation trips in the offseason.
So the mileage adding up for May and Walsh. AVP record 49-1, FIVP 26-1, and both losses to Wacholder and Youngs.
The second of those losses was a few weeks ago in Paris.
Kerri Walsh gets the serve, and Walsh thumps it through. Kerri Walsh, 26 years old. She has 44 career wins, three behind Misty May. She's eighth on the all-time list, two behind Linda Hanley. So Hanley behind May and ahead of Walsh, sandwiched in between. Wacholder pounds it out of bounds.
And you mentioned all those records, Chris. All those are going to be broken so badly because Walsh and May are so young. They have at least two, maybe three Olympics ahead of them, and all these wins that they're racking up, they're going to set records that are never going to be surpassed, or at least not for many years, with being two such special athletes to come along at the same time and to play together.
Elaine Youngs gets the kill. A kill is a successful spike, in case you're wondering. Walsh and May lead 6-4. Misty, Rachel is there. Wacholder, a very quick defensive player. Misty digs back. And the ball bumped out of bounds. So a good block by Elaine Youngs. Now that's not a stuff block. It won't count as a roof or a stuff, but a control block.
Absolutely, but the one mistake that we saw in that play is Misty May struggling a little right here on this set. It went way back, so far backwards that Kerri Walsh had to bump it over. That's a very, you just don't see that kind of mistake out of May and Walsh very often, and that's why they're 49-1.
In case you're wondering, Wacholder and Youngs did play in Europe also, so they are a bit groggy in terms of the travel, the same kind of travel that May and Walsh have been experiencing. Quick set, and Walsh can't block that one down. It's off her hands point.
And that's what we talked about at the top of the show, is Rachel Wacholder needs to challenge that block. She's done it very well so far. Challenge the strong, tall block of Kerri Walsh, who is number one on the tour in blocks.
6-6 our score. And they're serving Misty. Shank pass. Sets okay. Wacholder with the dig up 35 feet. And the put away. The bad set actually aiding the cause that time.
It sure did. It opened the court a little. Misty May didn't know which way to go. But you mentioned before about how Rachel Wacholder really isn't just a pretty face. I think I've underestimated, made a mistake in analyzing how good her game has been. It didn't give her enough of credit, I guess, because she played with Kerri Walsh last year, and Kerri Walsh picked up a couple of players and carried them to wins or almost wins. But Rachel is really playing the best volleyball of her career.
A 4-0 scoring run for Wacholder and Youngs. They have the lead at 7-6. Another dig for Wacholder. Nobody out. Good call by Youngs. 8-6. They change sides. The Nissan point leaders, a Nissan car, a one-year lease to each of the players that win. And it looks like May and Walsh have it locked up, or do they?
I think they're close, but these last few tournaments of the year are worth double or triple points. So these are very important tournaments to win the Nissan Points Championship. In fact, it was 2 years ago May and Walsh won it, and I think they both went for 350 Zs.
8-6. May. Wacholder runs it down. Youngs, chance for point. And she's got it. Solid play from Youngs and Wacholder.
Well, they really have Misty May dialed in right now. They tried Kerri Walsh early, didn't get many points off her, but Rachel Wacholder is touching everything that's getting popped by Youngs' block.
Misty blocked, and Youngs into the net.
One thing Elaine Youngs did mention, Chris, was that in the last couple of tournaments they played overseas, they felt like Misty May wasn't hitting the ball very hard, that she was shooting the ball well, but she sees the defense so well that she's placing the ball in the perfect spots in the court, but not so far today.
Elaine Youngs snaps one through.
And that's a smart play by May and Walsh there to mix it up. They didn't get any points off of Rachel for the last five, six tries, and that's the time when you want to switch up your strategy and try the other player and get Rachel Wacholder out of her strong offensive rhythm.
Here's Elaine Youngs, 31 career wins, just over $800,000 in prize money. Good strong serve. Over the top, Youngs has got it. Oh, and she shoves Kerri Walsh to the sand. That's one of the first times I can remember on any kind of a joust play where Youngs has gotten the better of Walsh.
Well, my old coach at UCLA, Al Skates, used to say the low man wins low woman wins the joust. Maybe Kerri was up a little too high on that play, and Elaine Youngs had more momentum going toward the net as she was able to push that one down. Great play.
Big shoveability on that play as Walsh hits the deck. 11-7 here in game one. 8 out of 9 points scored by Youngs and Wacholder. Over the top, and Misty May pokes it through.
Well, that was just an incredible set by Kerri Walsh there on a poor pass, pushing it all the way up to the net, and Misty May breaking out the knuckler, we call it. You can't contact the ball with an open hand, but you can use a couple of knuckles and put it into the deep corner.
Up, Misty.
You're right.
And she puts it away. Misty May over the top.
Misty May returning the favor. Wacholder did that a few times to her earlier, and just lining up, and it's not a sharp angle shot. It's one that goes almost toward the back corner of the court, and she makes a perfect dig. The important part of that, once you get that dig, Kerri Walsh has to put it up close for May to put it away, and she saw the block went right over it.
11 serving. Make that 9, serving 11. Walsh and May behind.
Line.
Quick set outside. May gobbles it up. And Misty May kills another one. So May and Walsh, after a slow start, they gave up 8 out of 9 points. And now they've scored 3 in a row. AVP on NBC will continue. Wacholder and Youngs on top by 1.
Hey! Self-defense, first rule, is 90% instinct. Like when I try to do this. Good. She covered. Now, what if I try to take your Bud Light?
Bud Light, great taste for your great times.
What's mine is mine.
Maria Bergman's Nature Valley. Lost Horse Creek, Bitterroot Range, Montana. Where's yours? 100% natural, whole grains, delicious. Nature Valley Granola Bars, the energy bar nature intended.
A shift has been made. Full-size truck party finally got interesting. A shift has been made, and the mid-size truck feels a whole lot bigger. A shift has been made, and when you think tough, powerful, innovative trucks, think Nissan.
Cool and overcast here in Southern California this weekend. The Huntington Beach Open presented by Bud Light. Kerri Walsh and Misty May. Rachel Wacholder and Elaine Youngs in our women's championship final. Youngs and Wacholder off to a good start. They led at one point 11-7, then 3 in a row for Kerri and Misty. And now it's 12-11. What's been the 12-10, I should say. What's been the difference so far in the match, Karch?
Well, both teams have been playing great defense, but that last play, Rachel Wacholder did a nice job of not just hitting toward the corner.
Youngs, yes. Youngs has some heat on her spikes. Very tough to dig her, and she had an open net that time.
That reminded me of the play they won in Cincinnati, one of the rare times she got to hit on an open net right here, putting the ball away. That was the winning point also in Cincinnati when Kerri Walsh chose to drop off the net instead of stay to block.
Hit speed today, 42 miles an hour. Remember, the ball is coming from about 5 or 6 feet away. Unlike baseball, it's coming very, very quickly. And May goes over the top. Well, we should tell you that Misty May, in our semifinal, told our reporter Heather Cox that she had been bothered the last couple of days by some food poisoning. She says she doesn't think it's going to be a factor, but when you have food poisoning and it does affect you, that could be something we look for down the line here.
She might have gotten some bad Wiener Schnitzel over in Austria and then had to deal with that on the last of those 17,000 miles, but
This way.
Being a cooler day today, I think, will definitely help anybody who's feeling a little under the weather. That when this hot sun comes out, it just puts that much more challenge on the body.
Misty May, one of the toughest players in beach volleyball. She is a grinder. Learned from her father, Butch, her mother, Barbara, both superior players and athletes. Here's Misty. And Misty rising to the occasion.
That's the third straight time that Misty May has come around behind Kerri Walsh and told Kerri Walsh, bump it behind you. I'm going to hit from the middle of the court. And it's the third straight time that she's cranked the sharp angle. Elaine Youngs needs to make an adjustment and take that ball away as a blocker.
14-12. Passes back. Wacholder. Another terrific set in the cut shot in front of Misty May. That cut shot may be important today.
Very much so, because with Elaine Youngs making such a great set there, the thing that Wacholder is going to be more effective at is mixing her tempos and mixing locations. If she just hits hard to the deep corner every time, Misty May is going to be all over that ball, gobble it up. But when she takes some heat off of it and just drops it in front, that's going to open other things up later.
15-12. Wacholder Youngs.
Another back set.
And the put away there. Now Rachel Wacholder, she has been the poster girl for the AVP in recent years, despite medium play. And you can see she is a very attractive young woman. I had a chance to ask her today if it's nice to finally get recognition for your volleyball skills. And she said, yes, it's really nice. You know, for a long time, people didn't pay attention to my volleyball skills. And you can see why. But now she's winning, and she's very grateful, interestingly, to Kerri Walsh, who gave her the first chance. Last year, she finally got to play with a great player. She proved she's good.
And her biggest worry was, is this going to be my only shot? Or was that it with Kerri? But she got to hook up with Elaine Youngs this year and really show the talent that she has. And I think she's clearly the vastly most improved player on the AVP Women's Tour this year.
Walsh opened the door, and now she's teaming with Elaine Youngs. Wacholder says she wants to get to the Olympics if she can in Beijing. And if this year was an Olympic year, they'd be the number two team for the United States, and they would be going.
Instead of gold and bronze, they could easily get gold and silver the way both teams are playing right now. In fact, just last weekend, we showed you that graphic traveling all over the world. They got first and second in Austria and dominated the rest of the world, handled all the great Brazilian teams easily.
16-14, Youngs and Wacholder continuing to lead. Nobody except Kerri Walsh. Youngs. And Youngs pounds it down. She doesn't look afraid of Kerri Walsh at all.
No, and she shouldn't be the way she's playing. She's really strong offensively so far this year and feels a lot of confidence after that win in Cincinnati. And Elaine Youngs has talked about how she's having the most fun in her career. Easy pass here for her. Challenges the block inside.
A three-point advantage for Youngs and Wacholder. Remember, the first two games are to 21, so they're closing in now.
Another back set for May.
And she is roofed. It landed right on the line. Youngs gets the block.
And finally, the fifth time Elaine Youngs took that away. You don't want to let a player hit five times in a row hard to the same location, but the thing, it's almost a bit of a chess game. Elaine Youngs was able to lure her hitting it into the block once again. As a player, I would be thinking, God, is she going to let me hit that ball a fifth time? Well, all right, I'll give it a try, and that one didn't work.
Young's off to a good start statistically and a four-point advantage.
Now staying in front.
And Misty socks one cross-court. So Misty May trying to find her rhythm after a couple of difficult weeks of travel. Dane Selznick had mentioned in an earlier match that they haven't practiced all that much.
No, before the last tournament in Hermosa Beach, they had had one practice in about 4.5 weeks, and very few. There's really almost no opportunity to practice when they're traveling back and forth from Europe.
18-15. Wacholder, Youngs, and Youngs out jumps Walsh. Wow, Youngs is springy today, Karch. It's two joust wins for EY.
Well, she feels like she's playing. She said it earlier today. Probably the best volleyball of her career. It really helps to have a strong offensive partner in Rachel Wacholder. And she feels, and she's actually lost about 5 pounds. We were noticing she's just in great shape, probably even better than she was going into Athens, and feels like she's jumping higher and playing great volleyball. She said last year that, she said, Karch, if I'm still playing after age 35, you probably just ought to come out and shoot me. But now she's saying Rachel is helping her extend her career, and she could see playing a number of years beyond this.
Maybe. Misty May hits it out. So Misty May clearly struggling. Wacholder and Youngs have elevated their game. And Wacholder and Youngs have their first game point. Crowd is alive. Pressure now on the gold medalist, Misty May.
We'll see if Misty May goes for that back bump set that she had success with earlier.
That's also a lot more work to do that. That's kind of a longer trail to circle out every time. We'll see. 20-15, Youngs to serve. Youngs has got it. And she puts it away. Elaine Youngs. Help me, Rhonda.
Wow, what an athletic play by Youngs when she got blocked to go so high above the net and get down on the ground and then cover ground laterally. You'll see it here in a minute after she makes this block up in the air. She's going to try to put it away right here. Gets blocked. And look at how she gets down and get one hand on that ball and then middle, and she cranked it down the middle for the game.
Elaine Youngs putting an exclamation point on game one. Youngs and Wacholder dominate the Olympic champions. We'll see how the gold medals respond after this. Stay with us.
Sponsor of the AVP Tour.
T-minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Liftoff. A new kind of energy drink fueled by Herbalife.
This is Halls. And this is Halls Fruit Breezers. A different kind of taste sensation from Halls that'll give your dry, scratchy throat a cooling lift. Halls Fruit Breezers. Treat your throat.
World champion Chelsea Mammel and rising star Nastia Liukin headline America's most prestigious gymnastics competition, the Visa Championships. Tonight, 7 Eastern, NBC.
I'll tell you what we need. We need some energy right now. You breaking out your jump serve? No? You want to keep floating? Okay. I'm just saying, we need to pick ourselves up, kind of change the speed. Okay?
May and Walsh lose game one. Let's go down to the sand. Heather Cox with Elaine Youngs.
And I'm joined by the only team that seems to know how to beat the number one team in the world. What do you know that nobody else does?
Hey, we're having fun today. I mean, this is fun. How can you beat it? This is a great crowd.
You know, they're a tough team, but we've had some good matches against them. We're confident. So we just want to show everybody out here in Huntington Beach what we're made of, and we just want to pull it out. They're going to come back really mad in this game, so we're prepared for it.
How do you carry the momentum into game two?
We just keep having fun and swinging at the ball. We're taking them out of their game by hitting, not just shooting the ball. So it's we're going to keeping up the aggressive mindset.
Impressive game one by both of you.
Elaine Youngs, unbelievably good in game one. Controlling the net, won a couple of jousts with Kerri Walsh, hitting the ball hard.
Go get it again. Right here. Get it deep.
As you said, Chris, you rarely see her winning on those joust plays against Kerri Walsh because Kerri Walsh has a couple inches on her height-wise, but Elaine Youngs seemingly jumping higher than she has in a couple of years in just great shape, playing phenomenal volleyball.
Start of game two, best two out of three game match. Youngs hit the nail on the head. May and Walsh are going to be steaming after that thumping. They got smoked in game one, 21-15.
When you do see them lose, it's usually 22-20, 23-21, but that was a thumping, and they're going to come back hard. Elaine Youngs said it just a moment ago. She's expecting them to up their game a lot.
Line them up.
Go, Kerri.
Nice tip. So Elaine Wacholder taps it through.
Again, another change of a nice change of pace there by Wacholder to keep Misty May honest on defense. If she hits hard to the angle every time, May's going to be dug in for it. But mixing in that soft shot over the line is going to open the rest of the court up.
Youngs, Wacholder. Rachel's there.
Hard.
Off the net, tough chance, and May can't get there. So Rachel Wacholder continues her fine play, 11 kills. You said at the top of the show in the Awkwafina strategy session that Rachel Wacholder would have to be steady, and she has been.
And she really has, and that's what's made this team even better and capable of beating Walsh and May, where Holly McPeak, Elaine Young's former partner and partner in winning a bronze medal, they didn't seem to have quite the same offensive skills. Holly had to run a different kind of offense, and Elaine Youngs feels much better being able to set the ball to Rachel Wacholder and rely on her strong offense.
Misty May pounds one cross court. Misty May, the 2004 Olympic gold medalist. She was a 2000 Olympian, finished fifth with Holly McPeak. And an injury-plagued Olympics. Now Kerri Walsh, jump serve. 2-2, game two.
Line.
Wacholder drills it. Misty May with a dig. Another dig. Rachel's there. Long rally. Who can put it away? Wacholder does. Wacholder told me earlier today that nobody paid attention to her career before now. Well, they're paying attention now.
And they have to. Both May and especially Wacholder in this rally making great defensive plays and finally getting at the end of this the great set close to the net. Rachel coming around behind for the first time. Digging that deep middle. Now Wacholder getting it back. And what was unusual about the end of that play was Misty May went for that soft line shot that opened up the angle for Wacholder to put down.
Youngs misses the serve, the ball back to May and Walsh. Walsh and May in finals, they won 42 of 50, 84% as a team. Karch Kerri for his career, if you're wondering, 72% in finals. Not too bad.
I'm actually surprised that Walsh and May are only at 84%.
Youngs.
Being 49-1 this year, they're 98% winning percentage.
That's kind of buffed them up, hasn't it?
That's going to work.
Wacholder and Youngs continue their good play.
This fall, there's something in the water.
Dude, what was that?
The fate of the Earth is in the hands of three strangers.
Eggs?
They just don't know it yet. Surface. NBC Mondays this fall.
What's it like to be the visited team in your own hometown? Catch our first game of the season and find out as we take on Air Force right here at Quest Field.
It's It's a new era in Husky football with Coach Tyrone Willingham. Get your tickets today for the season opener, Air Force versus Washington, September 3rd at Quest Field. Prime seats are available for non-season ticket holders. Get your tickets now at Ticketmaster.com.
I got total satisfaction in my experience with Pure Money Mart.
Pure Money Mart helped me to get my very first car.
Pure Money Mart, they actually care about getting you what you need, and they'll get you into a car that you want.
Not only did I leave there with a vehicle that's going to be reliable and help me rebuild my credit, but I have some friends there too now.
They're in the business of helping people. Customer satisfaction, that's their number one goal.
800-800-8553.
Protect your valuables with a state-of-the-art wireless home guard security system. No other security company offers a better value with zero down, zero interest financing on a custom system combined with low $23.95 monthly monitoring. HomeGuard offers voice alert,
kitchen, window, alarm,
a false alarm guarantee, and will even convert a competitor's system for free. Call today and compare, then rest easy and save with wireless, worryless security from HomeGuard.
Coverage you can count on from Mimi Chung and King 5 News.
Back in beautiful Huntington Beach, California. Our Bud Light tournament summary. Both these teams had to get by McPeak and Kessie to get into the final. It wasn't easy. McPeak and Kessie played very well this weekend. Yesterday, EY and Rachel had their hands full. And earlier this morning, Walsh and May grinding it out. Three outstanding teams on the AVP Tour Women's Division.
McPeak and Kessie pushed Wacholder and Youngs to the limit, going three games, losing just by two in the last, and then pushed May and Walsh to the limit. They were up 19-18 in the first game of that semifinal before losing two close games.
Rachel Wacholder with a serve. She's got the dig.
Nobody.
Walsh, yes. Great range. She was really encouraged with her semifinal play. She told me earlier in the 10th that they really scored a lot of points in the semifinal. Able to block a lot of balls and dig a lot of balls.
Scoring points on your serve is definitely a big key to putting pressure on the opponents. That means because a team has the advantage when receiving serve, not when serving the ball. When the ball is in your hands on offense, you're in much better shape.
Youngs is just teeing off at the net. She has 10 kills, all of them impressive. So a former basketball star at UCLA, Elaine Youngs, set to put the ball in play. 5-4, our score, and the serve missed. I believe that's two in a row for Youngs.
Well, the thing we talked about at the top of the show, they feel like they have to serve really tough, and missing one or two here and there is not going to worry them tremendously because they're playing great shape. They won the first game and 5-all in the second.
Bad pass by Wacholder. And Wacholder, on about an 8-foot back set, hits it straight down. Wow. Well done.
That was Kerri Walsh like hitting the ball down so well from off the net. And the best thing about this, any digger has to drop into the middle of the court a little, like Kerri Walsh did there. But knowing that, a hitter can adjust and hit it, even if it's not that hard, hitting it back toward the line is always going to be open when the blocker drops off.
Yeah, that's a winner virtually any time you hit that ball. Here's Misty. And Youngs up late, try to come out of nowhere, and Youngs.
And that was interesting on that play because Youngs and Wacholder were both taking the angle. Youngs was blocking the angle, Wacholder was digging the angle. We call that doubling up, and still Misty May put the ball away.
And on two is Elaine Youngs, the play that makes Karch Kerri hair stand on end when he sees on two.
And did you see her laugh and point right up at me? That was great. If she mixes it in very carefully, and that was the first one of this match so far, really chooses her spots, she's going to be successful on that. If she does it consistently, it's going to be almost impossible to put those down on May and Walsh.
Elaine Youngs playing superbly. 7-6, they lead. Wacholder with a dig. And Wacholder puts another one away. Rachel Wacholder, seventh year on tour, and she has come into her own. Elaine Youngs doing everything she needs to. At the net, bombing away. Youngs and Wacholder lead 8-6.
coupons at McDonald's from August 11th through the 14th. I just buy a sandwich and my medium fries and drink are free. It's a great offer that's totally five-star all the way.
Revolution, get down. Revolution, get down. Revolution, get down. Don't treat me like I was born for nothing, 99.
Every race is tight and every run is crucial. Ryan Gutler wowed the masses with his BMX dirt win in the Rockies, but two second place finishes has points leader Cameron White thirsting for his first win of the tour. The Vans Invitational, next Saturday, 2:30 Eastern, NBC.
Back in Huntington Beach, California, where the defending Olympic gold medalists are in trouble. That's right. Misty May and Kerri Walsh lost game one, got hammered 21-15. They trail here in game two, 8-6. What's been the problem, Karch, Kerri, for the gold medalists?
Well, Misty May hasn't been quite as strong offensively as she always is. In fact, for the last 2 years, teams have been serving at her and losing every time. Finally, teams decided to switch it to Kerri Walsh a little and having a tiny bit more success. But I think probably the effects of some of that food poisoning are taking its toll on Misty May and getting blocked a couple of times, getting dug, and not getting a ball like that up that she usually gets.
How good has Rachel Wacholder gotten? Well, I asked her this week about her sponsorship. She said, I just signed a new deal with Liftoff this weekend, so they're a new sponsor. I've got two meetings next week, and so she has become a hot property on the AVP Tour. And who wouldn't want to have her?
Well, the big thing is these two teams are now playing in every final.
Yes.
And when you're on television, you can get your sponsors a lot of exposure. That's particularly the case with May and Walsh, who have been on every minute of every women's broadcast this year on the AVP. But now that Youngs and Wacholder are on, they're in hot demand too because the sponsors know they'll be on those shows.
Wacholder taps it over the top.
And there's another great shot by Wacholder. When you mix in those soft shots, it keeps the great defense of Misty May off balance. She's not going to be able to tell whether the next hit that that Wacholder has is going to come hard or soft to a different part of the court.
Elaine Youngs to serve. 10-8, her team on top. After Misty again.
Nine.
And Misty powers one through.
And that is May's bread and butter. One of her favorite shots is cranking that angle. Either Wacholder has to get over there farther to play the ball, which then opens up a different part of the court, or Elaine Youngs has to reach farther to her right as a blocker.
Our stat man, Mike Sonheimer, tells us that Rachel Wacholder is hitting a percentage of 727. That's kills minus errors divided by attempts. Wacholder has been spectacular.
Good. Yeah. Low. Line. Come on, Miss. Come on, Miss.
And another loop shot over Misty May. So May is in tight, expecting the hit. And Wacholder making it look like a hit, but then giving it the loop.
Giving it the what they call the jumbo shrimp, rainbow to the corner, and that was a second time that May's missed that one. Very uncharacteristic of her, but Wacholder doing a great job again of mixing up tempos and locations on her hits. It's kind of like a pitcher can't get away with only the fastball in baseball.
11-9. And Walsh going on two, and she hit it out. The upset is brewing here in Huntington Beach. Youngs and Wacholder leading.
I built this car with my own two hands.
Nous avons subi de terribles pertes
et remporté des victoires magnifiques.
Hemos ganado muchos amigos, pero aún más enemigos.
多くのライバルに圧勝してきた。負けないよ。
È quella mia macchina. Credete di riuscire a batterci?
You are the designer. You are the driver. Forza Motorsport.
chance, you might not know who I am. But I'll give you a clue. I'm famous.
Not a chef.
I'm no boxer. But neither is he. Ain't no golfer. My fans know who I am. I'm Nelly. And your kids are your biggest fans. So talk to them about underage drinking.
Nelly, we're ready for you.
Let's go.
Don't tell me we don't have time to do a fancy lunch. Because now there's McDonald's all-new premium chicken sandwiches. Juicy chicken breast in my kind of flavors, like the ranch BLT and the club. And they're even handing out coupons at McDonald's from August 11th through the 14th. I just buy a sandwich and my medium fries and drink are free. It's a great offer that's totally five-star all the way.
May and Walsh, pop icons, Olympic heroes, the most lethal force on the sand. The Manhattan Beach Open presented by Bud Light. Next Saturday, 4:30 Eastern, NBC.
The AVP Nissan Series Huntington Beach Open presented by Bud Light is brought to you by Nissan, proud sponsor of the AVP and all things summer. By Xbox, it's good to play together. And by Gatorade Thirst Quencher. Gatorade, it's in the AVP. Is it in you? Back in Huntington Beach, Elaine Youngs and Rachel Wacholder winning game one, leading here in game two. Let's go down to the sand. Heather Cox with Elaine Young for a beach peek.
And up 13-9 behind a very explosive all-around game by Elaine Youngs. Let's take a look at your explosiveness at the net. What do you see?
All right, let's see here. Rachel makes a great set on this play, and I've got a lot of line. Kerri seems to do that to me, give me line, and I just made a good play. This one, I give Rachel a tight set. She makes a great cover. And again, I'm a big athletic player, and Kerri's also, so I was lucky enough to get it over her. This one, what do you say? I mean, I just hit it hard and hit it fast, and Rachel, again, made a great set. But this is fun out here. I'm having a good time.
Elaine Young's definitely taking advantage of the matchup with Kerri Walsh, guys.
And she is certainly not tortured by doubt today. I'm big and athletic, and what can you say about that hit? That was just going too fast.
You got to have opinions. Maybe she's got a future in commentating on herself that time.
So here we go, folks. Elaine Young's digging in. Misty May and Kerri Walsh behind 13-9, three in a row. Youngs has it. Flaps it up. Walsh whips it on one. So Kerri Walsh and Misty May, what do they have to do? What can they do to respond?
Well, Walsh has zero blocks so far, and they have to put more pressure on Wacholder and Youngs. Rachel Wacholder has made only one unforced error in this whole match. That is, those are phenomenally low numbers. So Kerri Walsh really has to take over and carry Misty May, because Misty doesn't seem to be quite herself today with the food poisoning. Something's got to give, and Kerri's got to make it happen here.
And that's the start. Walsh jams it down. 13-11.
It's kind of like when you watch Mike Lambert with his many partners. When he starts making those blocks at the net, that's when his partner can pick things up and play better defense. First block of the day, getting off the schneid on blocks for Kerri Walsh.
Short serve. Wacholder cuts. Beautiful. Rachel Wacholder with the cut shot. And the 14th point, Kerri and Lambert. By the way, congratulations on your big win yesterday. Sensational.
That was a lot of fun.
Yeah.
That was a serve that you saw us using a lot, but the women don't use it much, and that is a very short serve by Walsh. Created a great scoring opportunity, but Rachel Wacholder responded with a great cut shot.
Misty May receives her 28th straight serve. Wacholder's got it. The shot is just out. Wait, there's going to be an argument here. And the first referee, that is Rebecca Karstensen, saying it was on the line. And I think I saw a line jump. Crowd doesn't like it. The breaks that the gold medalists usually get, not happening today.
Well, on this play, it's almost looks like May is in front of. When she lays her left hand down there, she blocks the vision of the far linesman who's trying to make the call. So the referee actually had a better,
I think that was good,
line on that, and it did look like it hit the line. So that was the right call. Plus the second referee also called it in.
15-11, Youngs and Wacholder. Misty. It's just roofed. Elaine Youngs with her third block today.
And I think that's the way you want to play Misty May. Try to take away her favorite shot, the hard angle hit a lot, as a blocker, and make her hit the line more.
Now 16-11. That's and a huge Elaine lead in a 21-point game rally score.
And Elaine Youngs did a great job. Jumped way to her right, about 3 feet, to take away that sharp angle shot. See if she takes that same shot again or tries to take the line this time.
Misty lobs. It's good.
And that's what May is so good at, is seeing the court. She saw the open, saw Wacholder come to the line, hit the deep angle.
May Walsh in big trouble now, trailing by four.
Sport is sport. A foul's a foul. And a bat's a bat, even if it's flat. 10 feet on the west side is 10 feet on the east side. Football is football, unless it's football. Now, a win's a win, a loss is a loss. But no matter what, you better come with it. Because it's 90 feet to first, no matter where home is.
Great hairstyles. Amazing hair color. The work of an artist. Your stylist. Paul Mitchell, The Color. Created and used by the finest hairstylist in the world. You don't go to a drugstore or supermarket to get your hair cut. Why rely on a drugstore or supermarket for your hair color?
Treat yourself.
Protect your hair.
And trust your stylist.
Only your salon guarantees the real Paul Mitchell.
This is Halls. And this is Halls Fruit Breezers. A different kind of taste sensation from Halls that'll give your dry, scratchy throat a cooling lift. Halls Fruit Breezers. Treat your throat.
The Race to the Chase counts down on TNT. With only four races remaining, Tony Stewart looks to continue to outrun the competition as he gears up for a championship run. Jeff Gordon and Dale Earnhardt Jr. are on the outside looking in. With the cut looming, they must make their move at Michigan. Coverage begins next Saturday with Bud Pohl qualifying at 1.
Back at the Huntington Beach Open presented by Bud Light today, MetLife is navigating the skies of California to provide aerial coverage of the AVP Huntington Beach Open. The final match, look to the skies for the MetLife Blimps and plane as they team up with NBC throughout the Nissan Championship Series. Wacholder and Youngs doing a number on Kerri Walsh and Misty May. Dane Selznick, their coach, is wired up. Dane, what's going on out there?
They're playing a very good game. They're very aggressive. They're hitting everything. They're moving it around. EY has keyed in on Misty's hitting right now. Misty's struggling getting her feet to the ball and seeing the defense right now. So we're trying to adjust that to make things better.
Wacholder lobs, you know, one on the line.
It's tough defending a shot like that. You know, I mean, she's hitting the lines.
Dane, this is Karch. If Kerri Walsh has got to try and pick it up a little and get some energy and carry Misty a bit at this point with Misty struggling, what does she have to do different?
Well, I mentioned to Kerri that she can't run it too fast on the setting and think of a play on two.
Wacholder, Youngs is there.
This game looks like it's kind of out of reach right now unless we can pick it up offensively, because, hey, they're playing, in my mind, the best game of their life right now.
They and certainly are.
So it's, you know, 6 points behind at 18 is a tough comeback.
All right, Dane, earn your money as a coach. Figure out a way. We'll
Thanks.
Get back to you. Dane Selznick, his team in trouble now. And the tap. So make it 18-13. This is either going to be a big blowout for Youngs and Wacholder or one of the great comebacks of all time.
Well, really, Youngs and Wacholder just have to think, all right, the next three serves we receive, let's do what we've been doing all game, and we can put this out of reach.
Bad set. Youngs over the top. Yes. This is the first match that I've ever seen where Elaine Youngs has outplayed Kerri Walsh by a decisive margin.
And it has been since last year that Walsh and May lost two straight, but Misty May was hurt with an abdominal injury. It's been actually since July of 2002 since they've lost without an injury two straight. And that was to McPeak and Youngs, who probably outplayed.
Rachel Wacholder powders one. May has it. Off the net. Oh, my gosh. Youngs. Misty's got it. Misty, nobody up, and she finally puts it away. Wow.
Well, Youngs has got to be feeling. She came up with the best defensive play of her tournament right now later in this rally. Even though they didn't win, they've got to be thinking, God, everything's going so great for us. Watch Youngs come up with this dig right here. May struggling a little. It's tough to back off on her. She is such a strong offensive player, leaving her an open net, a net with no blocker. She's going to win most of those battles.
Up to Kerri Walsh now. Only one block on the day. Wacholder. Youngs for point number 20. And she tips it down. Elaine Youngs is jacked up. Dane Celtic said it right. This is the match of their lives right here. Elaine Youngs and Rachel Wacholder. Have championship point. Looking for their third win against May Walsh this year. Misty, cross court, yes. You can't afford a letdown. You have to keep playing hard now. Wacholder and Youngs. Youngs, I think she thought maybe it was a timeout or something.
As you talked about, Chris, it would have to be a huge letdown for them to win because now they have the advantage. Receiving serve, being on offense, they should be able to put this ball away.
Second championship point for Elaine Youngs and Rachel Wacholder. This could be it right here. Youngs on two. She hit it out. I'll tell you what, if I'm Walsh and May, I'm serving Youngs the rest of this little segment here. She looks like she's so jacked up. She may be, like, overhyped. 20-16. Could it happen? We'll see. Walsh to serve. They go to Wacholder. Wacholder for the win. And they've got it. Youngs and Wacholder have upset May and Walsh here in Huntington Beach.
And Youngs making the smart decision that play and going back to what worked for them so well. Rachel Wacholder nearly perfect on offense, only one unforced error. Give Rachel the ball, let her put that away. And what a match Wacholder and Youngs played.
Elaine Youngs is giddy, as is her partner Rachel Wacholder. The most dominating performance against the Olympic champions that we've seen, well, maybe ever. 21-15, 21-16, two games to none.
Hey, I want to say hi to Durango. Love you guys. Everyone out there.
Hi to Durango. Everybody in Durango, Colorado, jumping up and down.
Here's their bread and butter. Great pass from Wacholder and the handset from Youngs. And this play actually ended with the net call right there. Kerri Walsh trying to do something extra to make something happen for their team with Misty May struggling a little today.
So Youngs and Wacholder flawless. Once again, the last sweep in Manhattan Beach on June 6th of last year. Davis and Jordan and jumping for joy. Wacholder and Youngs establishing themselves as
easily this. Hey, I want to say hi to Durango. Love you guys. Everyone out there, Southern California, we love you all. Hey, we did it a third time this year. More.
Thanks, Becky Doll.
Ready for some more endorsement deals, I think, Chris.
We are coming back. The upset in Huntington Beach, California, demoralized just Elaine Young's, the match of her life. We'll hear from her after this.
This fall, there's something in the water.
You guys getting anything weird on radar?
Today, once again, I want to mention her, Liz Massakine, best coach in the world. She's done a great job for us, and thanks, Liz. I'd also like to thank a couple other people. My mom, who's here today, who I love to death. Nancy Arena, who taught me so much in my beach volleyball game. And my partner, Rachel, who's just playing better and better and better as we go along. She's becoming a star in this league.
Your opponent, Kerri Walsh, moments ago came up to give you a hug. What did she say?
She said congratulations, and you know, Kerri's a competitor. She wants to win. We all want to win. She hates to lose. I know it's been well documented, but that was very nice of her. And, you know, we have great relationships with them. It's just sometimes gets a little feisty on the court.
Rachel, we saw some incredible plays out there. Is this the best this team has ever played?
I think this is the best that we've played together at the same time. Like, there's been times when one of us has played spectacular and the other's played well, and that's good enough to win. But this time, I think we both played at the top of our games, and it felt great. We had a little bit of a rough day yesterday. I did, and I think that we got pretty lucky pulling out that win, and that, I think, gave us a lot of confidence, just that we can be down and we can still fight back and win when we're not playing well. And I have to wish my Grandpa Steve a happy birthday today. He's turning 94, and I love him very much, and we're very proud of him.
I'm sure he's very proud as well of a win. Now, all wins are wonderful, but coming in the championship against the number one team in the world, what kind of statement does this win make?
I just think that we're kind of creating a rivalry here, that this is the real deal. We're going to push him every weekend, hopefully, and I think this will be great for our sport. I think we're going to keep getting better, they're going to keep getting better, and this is going to help everyone.
Certainly an exciting rivalry.
One more thing. We have a lot of great teams on the AVP. Holly McPeak and Jen Kessie gave us all we can handle the other day. Diane DeNicoche, Tammy Leibel, they gave us a really tough match before this. So we've got a lot of good teams on the women's side, and, you know, we're just happy to win this one today.
Well, we were treated to an exceptional match. Congratulations to you both. Chris?
All right, since Liz Massakine took over right before Cincinnati, Wacholder and Youngs have won 3 out of 7 against the Olympic gold medalists. Yes, Grandpa Steve would be stoked today. Wacholder and Youngs do it. When we come back, we'll hear from Kerri and Misty. What went wrong? Or did anything go wrong? Was it just too much, Wacholder and Youngs? We'll find out after this.